Do you own multiple brands, or maybe you have multiple businesses and you want to try and work out how to run them with one Google Workspace account? Well, in this video, I'm going to cover everything you need to know about how to make a great decision on how to structure your Google accounts running multiple businesses. My name is Pete Moriarty, and we help businesses with their Google Workspace accounts. Check out our channel for plenty more videos. Now, we are talking today about making sure you have your businesses configured correctly when you have more than one business. Now, what usually happens when you're an entrepreneur and you want to scale and grow your business? Well, you probably get excited and you want to start more businesses because that's what us entrepreneurs do. Well, what tends to end up happening is business owners will come to us and they'll say, "Hey, Pete, you know, I've got these multiple domain names, I've got multiple businesses, and I don't know how to make them work. Should I put them in one Workspace account? Should I put them in multiple Workspace accounts? Can I put them together at a later date? Can I pull them apart at a later date?" You can do both of those things. You can do all of those things. And what this decision comes down to is what the actual cost is now and the cost later down the line as well. Now, first thing you need to understand one thing inside of Google Workspace, and that is the difference between alias domains and add-on domains. Now, an alias domain is basically where you have a one primary domain, and let's say for us, it's itgenius.com, but we wanna have an extra domain that works for all of our users. And so in my case, it's .com.au. And that domain is gonna work for any of our email addresses, for any of our staff, no matter what name they have. And anytime I add a new user, it's just automatically gonna show up and they're gonna have that extra alias in there. Now, that effectively works because it means that any users I create, they're automatically going to be assigned this new domain name. But everyone has to log in with the primary domain name, which in my case is .com. Everyone gets assigned a .com. You have to use that primary domain name. The .com.au just acts as an alias. Now, the add-on domains give you a extra little feature. And I like to call this buckets of email. We've talked about buckets before in some of my other videos on licensing. Well, buckets are an extra bucket that you can have mail going into as a completely separate user account. And if you would like your secondary domain, for me, it happens to be .com.au, to act as a second bucket and have users log into their own bucket using that secondary domain, well, that's the time when you want to use an add-on domain. And so that additional domain basically gives you the option to have a completely different domain under the same Google Workspace account. What would be the reason that you would want to use this? Well, if you're one business with multiple brands, that would make sense to potentially use different buckets for different brands so your team can email in and out using the different buckets. Or it might make sense if you literally have two different businesses, but you've got people working across the different brands and across the different businesses. You might have one human who's doing sales for two businesses, or doing customer service for two businesses, or doing finance for two businesses. Now, before we get into when you should and when you shouldn't, I want to talk about some of the technical limitations of actually having multiple domains in one account, because there are some limitations. Now, one of those limitations are if you're using something like alias domains, well, calendar invitations are only ever going to go out from the primary domain. So when you send an email from a primary domain, or you invite someone to your calendar event, you can't use the secondary domain. So that can be a little bit of a pain unless you're using the bucket system. When you use the bucket system, then you're going to be able to use different domain name and therefore it's going to have different calendar invitations. The other thing is when you have one Google account, if you share a shared drive outside your business, well, customers are going to see the business name next to those shared drives. So you would have to choose a business name that is generic enough that would make sense for your businesses if you are sharing shared files outside your business. Now, you might not care about that, but if one of your businesses is a professional services business, like maybe an accounting firm, and your secondary business is online dog food, well, it may look a little bit weird if you're sharing a shared drive and it has your online dog food domain name, they're going to your accounting clients. So that might be one reason that you want to do things completely separate outside of the domain in a completely separate Google account. There are some other things like if you're using the classic version of Google Sites, that used to actually have the URL of the Google account in the domain name. And so inside that URL, you would be locked to basically using the primary domain name And that would make things challenging there. Google also does something really clever with its sharing. And that's basically anyone under one Google account has certain things shared with each other. You can have a company-wide policy to allow everyone read-only access of each other's calendars. You can have a company-wide policy to automatically share files or allow file sharing within the company. You could even say any file that has link sharing enabled is automatically going to be shared with everyone inside the company. There are plenty of ways of, you know, automatically having collaboration happening inside your business, even when you have multiple domain names running under one Workspace account. Now, the downside of that is if you have, for example, other people involved in your business or you have quite large teams, it can turn into a little bit of mess trying to, you know, have things unlinked once you've got everything linked and everything shared. So if the security is important between the different businesses and you want to make sure you have clearly defined sharing between the different businesses in that, you know, if they're completely separate organizations or companies, you probably want to have them separate. It might not make sense to have everything in the same basket there. And next implication to talk about is the cost implication. There are cost impacts whether you have one Workspace account that you want to split out and separate into two, or if you have two Workspace accounts that you want to combine and merge into one. Now, both of these operations are possible without losing any data or emails and, you know, maintaining all of your user accounts and all those kind of things. Those specialist migration services are what we do at IT Genius day in and day out. And so if you need help with that, actually making that happen with no lost emails and without any flaws, then click on the link below and get in touch with our team. But it's important for you to recognize that if you start a business and you have multiple brands and you grow that business and all of a sudden you've got 20 or 30 employees, well, at some point you're going to have to demerge or, you know, remove and separate those two Google accounts. And that's going to be costly because of the cost of migration. And that cost exponentially increases the number of users that you have. Now, we've had companies come to us with 200 employees all under one Google account, and we've had to, like, you know, pull those accounts apart bit by bit. And that, of course, gets very expensive. So that's the thing to think about. It is possible, absolutely, to, you know, remove the data and move it into separate accounts. And that's totally fine. You may just say, you know what, I'll worry about that later. And when the business is bigger, I'll have more money to invest in that. But that is certainly something to be mindful of anytime you're considering putting two brands or businesses into one. The final thing I'll say is that if you have business partners or directors in any one of those brands or businesses that are outside your business, and you don't really want them to be seeing all the data of your other company, or you don't want them to be stuck meddling with any of the users in your other company, in that sense, it's probably easy to just keep things separate. And what that means is there's no risk of one of your other directors being a super admin of your account and, you know, bumping off one of the staff on the other side of your business. It just keeps things completely separate, church and state, nice and separate. And what that does is it means that you don't have any risk of someone accidentally being shared the wrong thing. Basic rule is if they are actually two businesses, two separate discrete businesses, if they're in different industries, it probably makes sense for you to have two completely separate Google accounts. It would only make sense if you have the same team, the same directors, a similar business and industry, and just two brands that you happen to be running in the front end for you to keep everything together in one account. Hope that's answered it. If you've got any questions, drop them down below. I'll catch you in the next video. And if you're already a subscriber to Google Workspace and you're not yet working with IT Genius, well, you might be interested in our transfer in offer below, which the link is just down there. That gives businesses using Google Workspace access to our professional support team for some very basic support for free, which is pretty cool. You get access to discounts not usually available to the public. And we have an amazing Genius Academy, which is a free resource of videos for business owners using Workspace to help you and your staff get more out of the platform. If you're interested in that, click the link below. If you're not yet subscribed, hit that subscribe button. Give us a thumbs up if you like this content, and I'll see you in the next video.